apart so you can understand it. And some people are missing years so they won't get the full state pension. For example, years abroad, or you had a low income so you weren't earning that much. So this is the first thing I want you to do. And you know, you could do it even if you're under 45, because it's quite interesting. Let me move on. I want you to check your national insurance years. So you go to gov.uk, this is if you're not at state pension age yet, and check your state pension forecast. That's a full pension forecast for someone that we've got there. That will be interesting, and then click the link that says view your national insurance record. If you're over state pension age already, you just go straight to checking your national insurance record, all on gov.uk, and it will tell you whether you are missing any years. Let's move on from that. Now, if you do have a shortfall, you can buy more years. And this is the bit that is time sensitive. Until April 2023, you can buy national insurance years back to 2006. After that, you can only go back 6 years. So if you have national insurance gaps for the years from 2006 to 2017, you need to decide soon whether you are going to buy them or you will lose the opportunity to do so. Now, if you're near state pension age, I'm just looking around now, I'm not going to pick anyone out, then it's easier to see if it's worth it for you. The younger you are, the more time you'll have to naturally plug any gaps yourself, which is why I said it was only for people aged over 45. In reality, it might be only 50 or 55, but it's worth having a look if you're that age. If you're younger, then it will be work that should be able to pick it up, so it'd be a risk buying, because you might already get to your state pension years without anything. It's also worth noting, if you're missing years, you may be due national insurance credits for free, which you can check on the gov.uk national insurance credits page. For example, carer's credit or childcare, or if you have an illness. So always check that first before buying any. Now let me move to my calculator. Bring it out here. There we go. Here's the maths. A voluntary national insurance year costs around £800, around-ish. I have to do those caveats. And it adds £275 a year to your state pension. So the break-even point is 3 years. So if you live 3 years beyond state pension age, or if you're already at state pension age, 3 years beyond the point you get this, your quid's in. So let's look at typical life expectancy. First, for a man. A man who gets to age 66 will typically live 19 more years. So each £800 in that case would get him £5,300 back, and that's before the fact that it's normally linked with inflation. Obviously, that's another discussion at the moment for another day, but £5,300. For a woman, because women live longer, 21 more years at the same age, each £800 would be worth £5,800 extra, and there are calculators available online so you can see. So, look, we're talking real money, and it's really worth doing. Of course, you would have to have the cash to do it. But then, let's make this a little bit more difficult. First of all, please, do not rely solely on what you are hearing me say. This is complicated, and I have simplified it to give you a call to arms to who should be checking it out. Always contact the government's Future Pension Centre for a bespoke calculation to tell you what would happen in your case before you pay any money out. And I'm afraid I also have what I am calling a baboon warning. Lots of buts. Right? Lots of buts. Even once you've gone to them, they won't talk to you about the fact that if you're on a lower income and you don't have a big pension, you might be entitled to pension credit for a top-up, therefore paying money to top up your normal state pension won't give you as much back. Or the fact that if you're a higher earner, that this might put you into a higher tax bracket, which would take some of the gain away. So there are lots of complexities here, but big picture, for most people, if you're short of national insurance years and you're getting near state pension age and they're not available for free, then buying them is worth decent cash. Did that make sense?